the world. I'm worried about taking a couple of L's. Don't sin for me, just win for me. Don't kill for me, just live for me. Keep it real for me. We eat together, leave the bill for me. Like,
hand on my heart, I give it all I got. Walk the walk inside the talk. Take it higher, that's a God. Hand on my heart, no, I give it all I got. Walk the walk, talk the talk. Take it higher, that's a God. Never stopping, that's a must. Always winning, never lost. GPS, I never lost. GPS, I never lost.
Who do it better than me, yeah? Vision on 2020, yeah. BBS, Club ID, yeah. Determination, laser focus, banging on they door, they taking notice, taking notice, taking notice. Determination, laser focus, banging on they door, they taking notice.
The young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable.
All right, coach. So this old place, not quite done yet. There is playoff football to be played in the East Bay in Oakland, California. Today we continue on in Wild Card Weekend with a great AFC matchup between the Houston Texans and the Oakland Raiders. The battle for the Lamar Hunt Trophy begins as we're underway in this AFC Wild Card game. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
Xavier Woods on the tackle.
Looking to throw on second down. Fields escaping the pressure right. That's to Dalvin Cook, his running back. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 7 yards there and a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On the ground, it's Cook. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And finally marked down at the 23. That one good for 37 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Cook. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Now it looks like we've got a Raider here, slow to get up. We'll take a break and get a report from Oakland after this. Here's the first carry for Bo Scarborough. And this will be a gain of 6 when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Now Scarborough. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. A stop there on third. They could have held him to 3 on this opening drive. Now they have to bow their necks on first and goal.
And if I'm looking at this from the offense's point of view, that's a big-time pickup right there. And I'd go right at him with another momentum play. I'd go quickly and attack him because right now they probably have their heads down a little bit since they didn't stop him on third down.
So first and goal and an opportunity for our first points in this wild card game. Now they'll run it with Scarborough. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator? Remember what he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
Down. 30 base. Check 56.
Watch the out. Watch the out.
80 weapons.
Over.
61, matchbox lights. Check. Hey, lock it. Shoot.
They'll run on first down. It's Ross. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A pickup of 11 at a Texans first down.
A good run there off right tackle in an old school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
Let's go.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Check, check. Right now. Right.
They'll try the left side. It's Ross. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
On the set. Look, look, squeeze.
Let's go, defense. Let's go, defense. Oh, here we go.
On second down, it's Ross. 3 yards on the pickup there, but they've only got it back to third and 10.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments and doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Let's go, D. Let's go, D.
Come on, set. AT Gator.
E. Hey, watch the slam.
Defense.
Jones to throw on third down. He rifles one that's intercepted. He's picked off near his own 48. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
The 20. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Dalvin Cook, 49 yards. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it first and 10. On first down, Ross. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
And an alley to run. There he goes. throws right side. Touchdown, Houston. John Ross, 61 yards, as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Extra point from McManus is good, and that'll make our score 14-7. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Yeah, let's go sack lunch.
Off play action, Fields. Able to get this to Gordon. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
And Barton, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
And they're left looking at third and eight after the second down pass play only went for two. From the gun, Fields. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the... He's got a man, complete! Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. It'll go as a gain of 33, and that play started back at their own 33.
First down. First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Getting the ball is Cook, running left. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. They'll try the left side. Carter, and he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs, and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Throwing on first down, Fields. And this is Cook with a grab. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Delvin Cook, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And it's now 21-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. Second and six, just inside the 30. They'll try the left side. It's Ross. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, with the kind of half he's had, I think we can forgive him that run, right? Not every run's going to be a big play, is it?
No, and also the blocking just wasn't there. No room to run.
Yeah, defensively, they got to find a way to build on that because he's eating them alive in the first half.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Switch. Switch.
Snap. Now Jones on third down. This is caught by Robinson. 10 yards there. Good enough for a Texan first down. A little tough on the secondary there. In zone defensively. Quarterback had time to survey and find a spot.
And if you want to change things up and put a little more pressure on him, you can go to man coverage. Everyone matches up and send more pressure. But you can also do it out of zone coverage if you're worried about what's going to happen on your back end. Send someone else, drop someone else out of the line. The old zone blitz could come into play to try and get that pressure on the quarterback.
Let's go now.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. And again, this time to the tailback. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He came out ready to play. That's three tackles for a loss, Charles. We're only in the second quarter.
And that's problematic for the guys trying to run offense because that means he's got a pretty good idea of what they're doing and is actually beating them to the point of attack and making those plays. Might have to think about some misdirection or something to try and get him away from the ball.
On second down now, it's Ross. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Here we go, here we go. 50, plant.
Dude. On third down, Jones. That's complete to Robinson. And he's going to come up a few yards short. Brought down at the 45. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. They're going to try and throw. That's to his running back, complete. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out. And the Raiders with the football now in excellent field position.
Ready? 54, right there, right there. 54, Mike. It's going to be a long...
First down, here's the run with Cook. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Yeah, and let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises, and he's running with terrific ability right now.
And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. 2 minutes to play here in this first half of the NFL playoffs. Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown of what's going on. And he's over the line and in for a Raider touchdown. Dalvin Cook saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They trail here by 24 points. Got to get going soon, you'd have to think, as they come up first and 10. They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and 6. And give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and 6.
It's now second and 6 at the 29-yard line.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
General West, the grip.
They'll try the left side. Ross. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up 3rd down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
Ready, ready. Leo.
Watch the curve.
Chance.
And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on 4th down, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it here. And this is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Raiders with the football now in excellent field position. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over 150 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
On 2nd down, it's Cook. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a 1st down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the 2nd of their timeouts
as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. On first and 10, Fields. And this is caught at the 8. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. From the gun, Fields. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Mecole Hardman in the final seconds of the first half. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. Here's Badgley now to try to add the PAT. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will they be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'd love to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
Both teams try to avoid being one and done in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wildcard game. This is fielded at the goal line. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never wanted to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him. But instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive game.
Ready to break.
Let him know.
Let's go.
On third down, it's Ross. And forget that 100-yard rushing game, at least for the moment, as he'll lose yardage here and fall back under the century mark for the game.
Jet bomber.
Stop your whining.
Under 10.
Boy, and now they can't even get a playoff. And that'll set them back 5. And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and 9.
Keep it up. Keep it up. Check 24. Check 24.
Ready, ready.
Here's Jones throwing on fourth down. Open man is Sims. He's got it. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A big one there for the Texans, 18 yards. A couple of first downs as the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
Here we go. Set. 70. Indy.
Watch the run.
They'll keep it on the ground. Ross. And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he's had a meeting with his running backs.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Jonathan Abram picks it. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Again, it's Cook. Cook with a first down and much more. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. It's been an excellent day for him running the football, no doubt, as he continues to soar well past 100 yards.
Yeah, it almost feels like he can just grab his briefcase and head home after putting in a full day's work at the office, doesn't it?
Following the good run by Cook, here's another first and 10. Now they try the right side here. And he only manages a couple here down to about the 38-yard line.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Mike. Check 55, Mike. Ricky. You got tight.
On second down now, it's Cook. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Given 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on it.
He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Mecole Hardman. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And all he takes off with it, it's a fake.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be taken in at the 1. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point.
Ready up.
Come on, guys, 55.
Bam, bam.
Check three.
Fight.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Ross. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end.
Hey,
you don't want to see me.
To throw on third down, Jones. And he's got his man, Hilton. His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down.
T.Y. Hilton, a gain of 15, and the Texans' first down.
Okay, ready?
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Let's go.
One quarter remains for the right to survive round one here in the AFC. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Ready? 15, Lonnie. 15, Lonnie.
It's just me and you.
They'll run on first down. It's Ross, and he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Set up, 10 Lobo.
Watch the screen.
Hit it.
Get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A pickup of 11 at a Texans first down. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
A couple of first downs has the football position at the 43 as they come up first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And some space here. That's good for a Texan first down, a 12-yard pickup.
Man, these guys may not win this ball game, but you certainly can't fault the effort of this man here today. He's been a real thorn in their sides all afternoon. And that last carry puts him over the 100-yard mark.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 45-yard line. They'll run on first down with Marlon Mack. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5.
It's our time, guys.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And that'll bring up a third down. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Ross, and he gets this only to the 41. Not near enough for the first. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
It's now fourth down.
Ready?
They're already slim. Hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. On fourth down, Jones. And down he goes. A sack. They sack him back across midfield at about the 48-yard line. DeMarcus Lawrence. And it'll be a turnover on downs. Off the play fake. Fields. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down. They're still throwing the football here. Now, obviously, the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving. Keep them moving.
Yeah, I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. Now a pass dumped on to his running back. Cook able to escape. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A Raider first down, 17 yards. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
First and 10 at the 11-yard line.
54 is Mike, 54 is Mike. Check, check, watch 54, watch 54.
Shut up, me and you
are. Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon, it's Cook. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. A gain of 3, second down.
Like any team, they would have loved to have had more yards on that run, but it looks like they just want to get to the two-minute warning and see what they want to do after that.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. To throw on second down, Fields. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Mecole Hardman, the intended target. And that takes us from second to third down.
When you got your backs in the shadow of your goal line, you've got to be physical in that situation because there's not a whole lot of space, not a lot of wild plays that can be run there.
That's put up or shut up time. Defensively, nice job just to make sure they didn't complete it on that play. They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. He may try and run, and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
So they are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Throwing on second and 14. Jones got a man open. It's Ross. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Here we go! 60 Pittsburgh!
You remember me? You remember me? Let's go, baby!
Fight!
Houston, John Ross, he scored on the ground and through the air, and the Texans claw one back. Now McManus to tack on the extra point. And they make the score a little bit more respectable here in our final quarter of play.
Raiders 48, Texans 14.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Oakland offense about ready to start this next drive. And three timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point, as this one is all but over.
If they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show. We got a plane to catch.
Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
Oh, here we go.
Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. Second and four. Gets it to Gordon. And he's got room. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout. It'll be their third and final timeout. So as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Looking to throw. Fields. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. And a wild card win moves them on to the divisional round.
Everyone plays all year long for the right to get into the tournament, as they like to call it. Wild card, divisional, doesn't matter to them. One moves on, one goes home.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Black Hole celebrates. The Raiders are winners here as we say so long from Oakland.
ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Are you ready?
Get ready now.
This be the green light. Go. Ties burn the